Welcome to Footnotes, the Cicerone podcast, a podcast to inspire you about outdoor travel and activities in the UK and across the world. I'm Amy Hodkin. I'm a production editor at Cicerone, and I also work in the marketing department on these podcasts and on our live events. In terms of the outdoors, I enjoy walking, and I've done some long distance routes in the UK and in the Alps, and I've also started getting into fell running since moving back up to the Lake District.
I'm Hannah Stevenson, and I'm the marketing manager at Cicerone, and I wouldn't really call myself a walker or a trekker or a cyclist or a runner, but I do like giving things a go, and I really like exploring new places with my dogs.
So we thought a good way to kick off Footnotes Cicerone podcast would be with an introduction of who we are, the type of guidebooks that we produce. So to talk about all of that, we are joined by another member of the Cicerone team, Joe Williams.
Thanks, Amy. Yeah, I'm Joe Williams. I'm Cicerone's Business Development Director. Been at the company for about 5 years now, and I'm responsible for running the marketing program and deciding which nice new books and new editions we all get to work on and which ones we get to publish. Personally, I'm really into everything outdoorsy, whether it's mountaineering, trail running, fell running, rock climbing, walking, trekking, skiing, lots of other things that I can't remember. I think I'm a bit average at them all, but it's good to get involved with everything, really.
You might say that you are quite average at these things, Joe, but the people in the office who usually do things like park run or a bike ride at the weekend think that you are a little bit of a superman. What sort of things have you been doing in the past couple of years?
I wouldn't really say superman. But I suppose I'm quite good at the long distance side of things, and just particularly when it comes to ultra running and running 100 mile sort of distances and again, long mountaineering things in the Alps. Yeah, I think that the more time that you get to spend out in the hills, the better, really.
How important to Cicerone is it that all the staff are really outdoorsy?
It's a good question. I think it really does help. I think particularly from an editing side, I think it's really great that all of our editors are keen walkers or cyclists or whatever kind of activity it might be. It really means that they're able to ensure that exactly the right information is going into the books to be most useful for everyone out there using them.
And in terms of why Cicerone was set up and the origins of the business, that is also a key thing there, isn't it? The love of the outdoors.
Yeah, Cicerone was founded in 1969 by Walt Unsworth and Brian Evans, who at that time were unsatisfied with the offerings there were for guidebooks, for walking and for rock climbing. So they just thought, I think we can probably do better. And their ethos at that time, which has really remained to now, was that Cicerone was going to be producing guidebooks for walkers and climbers by walkers and climbers. And yeah, that's really stuck over that time. Walt and Brian eventually sold Cicerone to Jonathan and Leslie Williams in 1999. Jonathan and Leslie were a passionate trekking couple who were excited about a new challenge from a business side of things that really aligned to their own personal interests.
We've evolved now at Cicerone, not just for guidebooks for walkers and climbers. So who else do we write the guidebooks for?
Activity-wise, we cover everything from easy walking to long-distance trekking, mountain biking, road cycling, running, fastpacking, and mountaineering, ski touring. I think trekking's the big one, really, particularly for longer distance, multi-day, multi-week, sometimes multi-month routes in one of the most amazing mountain areas on the planet, whether that's in North America or the Himalaya or in South America.
And we do have books covering all over the world and in some really incredible places.
Yeah, that's right. And there's really quite a spread. We've got nearly 400 guides altogether, and therefore regions all around the world. Of course, everywhere in the UK, Ireland, throughout Europe, North America, South America, Africa, Asia, in the Himalayas. Even this year, we published a guide to the Overland Track in Australia. We're lucky in the Lake District. We've got several guidebooks that we can choose for walking in the area from the Cicerone stable. But we could go to the Himalaya and have the option to be trekking in the Everest region or in Annapurna. We could be going to Japan and doing either a pilgrimage there or going up Mount Fuji. We could go to Africa and trek up Kilimanjaro. We could go to South America and trek the Torres del Paine circuit down there. Yeah, there's a really great spread of options. It's quite exciting actually working at the company to think of what your next holiday could be.
And we've even got a guidebook to polar exploration, although I don't think that's quite as popular as all that.
It's not that popular. It's pretty specialist stuff.
So Cicerone has been producing guidebooks for over 50 years, and we now have nearly 400 titles covering, as you said, all regions and activities. But what were the first books that Cicerone produced and how have those developed?
Yeah, the first books were a couple of rock climbing books to the Lake District and a guidebook called Winter Climbs, Ben Nevis and Glencoe. That book is actually still in print, but in its seventh edition now. There've been multiple authors over those past 50 years for that particular book, and it's grown and evolved over time. We can then look at another book that was published in the 70s called Walks and Climbs in the Pyrenees. This is written by Kev Reynolds, who's one of our most prolific authors. And Kev's looked after that book and it's grown and evolved for all those years. And again, Walks and Climbs in the Pyrenees is still a really popular book. But more recently, it's evolved to looking at the national trails in the UK and coming up with an option to be able to get all of the maps that you might need tucked into a little booklet in the bag. And we've been creating ebooks for several years as well for all of our guides. So yeah, we've always been looking to not only expand the range of guidebooks that we've got, but also improve the quality consistently as well.
So at Cicerone, we've got sales and marketing and designers and editors. But who actually writes the books?
Unfortunately, we don't write the books ourselves at all. I think a lot of people assume that we do. But actually, it's a team of over 100 expert authors that we work with on an individual basis. So they're split between being either expert guidebook writers or local experts. So somebody like Paddy Dillon, who's a familiar name to many people who might have walked routes like the Southwest Coast Path or have been walking on the Canary Islands. Paddy is what I'd call a full-time expert guidebook writer. He's always off on some trip researching a new guide or updating one of his existing ones. And then we might go to local experts. So people that would be based in a particular part of the Alps and be specialists in that, their local trek or their local area. It's always brilliant to see how passionate and excited they are about their area and to see how much they care about every route and the book itself. It's information that you can trust, written by experts that know these areas really well, and with the book being prepared by a team in the publishing house that really know about walking or cycling. So you know that it's a really thoroughly checked and researched project and that you can rely on it and you can trust it.
Thanks so much, Joe, for talking to us about the history of Cicerone, who we are, the sort of books we produce and the team of authors that we have and our in-house team. And one of the things that we're looking to do with this podcast is being able to speak to our authors and outdoor experts and hopefully sharing their expertise with you and, yeah, hearing the behind the scenes process of actually making these guidebooks. And we hope we can share that with you. If you want to find out more about the full history of Cicerone, you can find that on the Cicerone website or in our 50 Years of Adventure book, because in 2019, Cicerone celebrated our 50-year anniversary. So you can find all the information about that, and it's celebrated and documented in that 50 years of adventure book. So thank you so much for joining us for this episode of Footnotes, the Cicerone podcast, where we've been speaking to Joe Williams. This podcast will be released fortnightly, so you can subscribe on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or iTunes, Google Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts from. We'll be across all sorts of streaming sites and apps. And you can let us know what you think by leaving reviews on those platforms, or you can email us live@cicerone.co.uk. We'd really love to hear from you and, yeah, what you think of the podcast. You can let us know if there's any specific questions you have or things that you'd like us to cover, and we'll try and put an episode together based around that.
If you're interested in finding out more about Cicerone, you can read over 1,000 articles at cicerone.co.uk, as well as buy any of our 400 books and sign up to our fortnightly newsletter. Search for at Cicerone Press on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter to find out all of our news, or you can join our community, Cicerone Connect, on Facebook for news, updates on the podcast, live events, new guidebooks, and plenty of information, special offers, and competitions. We hope you enjoy hearing about outdoor travel in the UK and across the world, and that you are inspired to set out on your next outdoor adventure. We look forward to hearing from you soon.